Which filament type resists the best to the bending and which one to the impact? What is the most temperature resistant filament type? And these are some of those questions which I'll try to answer in this video. If you're not familiar, I'm doing a lot of filament testing on this channel and I'm always using the same testing methods, so the results are comparable with each other. And every data is available separately for each video, but for my Patreon supporters, I'm collecting this data into one summary Excel table so they can easily compare this data with those which I did in earlier videos. Now, this is the first time I'm doing some deeper analyzing of this table and I found some interesting results, and that's why I decided to create this video to share with others. Now, since this is my only gift to my Patreon supporters, there will be no numbers in this video, but it will be more like a relative comparison of these filament types relative to each other for specific stress type. First, I want to explain you the graphs you will see soon in this presentation. Let's say we have an example test for these materials. These are the measured values. First, I need to calculate the average values. Copy them. And then I need a maximum value. And this will be the maximal value in the percentage. Of course, I need this in the percentage. And this will be presented on the graph. This is just a regular column graph. Adding the data labels for easier comparison. So this type of graphs you will see in this presentation, one of the types will be the 100%, the maximum value, and all other will be relative to this value, so you can easily compare them. And now let's start with the presentation. Here you can see how many data is included in this video. And then let's start with the tensile test. These test objects are printed in horizontal position. Smallest cross-section area 4x4 mm, and I'm only measuring the brake load. Unfortunately, I cannot measure the prolongation with my current equipment. I ordered a tensile testing machine from China, but it will arrive in 3 months approximately. Okay, so from here we can see that the polycarbonate is far the strongest, and then we can see the nylon, PLA and the other filaments. Now, even if they are more or less very similar, the PLA will break suddenly, until with the nylon we can see some deformation before the break. But unfortunately, I cannot measure this with my current equipment. The layer adhesion, these test objects are printed in vertical position, and again, smallest cross-section area is 4x4 mm, and I'm measuring only the brake load. And far the strongest here is the nylon. I even tested some nylons which have similar strength in X, Y and Z direction. This is really incredible. And then we have other filaments, more or less similar brake loads. Now with the ASA and ABS, it is important to mention that they are very sensitive to cooling, a little bit stronger cooling, and they have weaker layer adhesion. But sometimes we need this to print those overhangs and similar. Probably we have something similar with the nylon and polycarbonate, but this I didn't test it yet. There will be a very detailed video about this for the ABS or ASA filament. Two-sided shear stress. The diameter of the test objects is 5 mm, and again I'm measuring the maximal brake load. And here we can see that the polycarbonate and nylon are strongest in this test, but it is also important to mention that in most cases these are reinforced with carbon fibers or glass fibers. So in this case, besides they are printed in horizontal position, these fibers may help in this test. I started recently testing the shear stress with objects printed in vertical position. Their layer adhesion is also very important, but I started with this only a few months ago, so I don't have enough data to include them in this video. The torque or twist test. The diameter of the test objects is 6 mm. They are printed in horizontal position, and I'm measuring the load at a 90 degree rotation. And we can see the polycarbonate is the best in this test, then the PLA. Now the weakest is the PETG and the nylon, but it is also very important to mention that they are more flexible materials, so with them we can easier make those 90 degree rotation. And if I measure the maximal torque, in that case we can see that they are closer now and there is no big difference in now compared to the others. So it is important to remember that these two filaments are more flexible compared to other materials. Few months ago, I started the same testing with the same dimension test object, but printed in vertical position. So the layer adhesion is important there. And so far, interesting to see that the brake load is very similar with those printed in horizontal position, but it breaks more suddenly. Only I don't have enough data to include this in this video. the DIY azote impact test, and here again far the strongest is the nylon, and then ABS, ASA. The polycarbonate is very brittle, but sometimes it depends on the material. Usually they are reinforced with carbon fibers, those are extremely brittle materials. And then, yes, the PLA is tougher material compared to the PETG. And here I even removed the semi-soft and semi-flex PLAs because they would completely deform this test. Also, it is important to mention that in the polycarbonate I can see very big differences. For example, check the PolyLite and PolyMax PC filaments, a very big difference in the impact resistance. On 3-point bending test, I have different loads and I measure the deformation after 1, 30 and 60 seconds. And on this graph, you can see the results for the bending under 5 kg and the deformation after 60 seconds. And smaller values are better, of course. And here we can see the biggest deformation on the nylon material. And the strongest in this test is the polycarbonate, then the PLA and then the other materials. Now this is again the 5 kg load, but I am analyzing the deformation after 1 and after 60 seconds. And here we can see the nylon deforms quite a lot during this time, so the creeping is very bad for this nylon, and the strongest is the polycarbonate. The creep test, the deformation under a constant load of 1.25 kg, and I'm measuring the distance between two reference surfaces, which is 12 mm without load. Blue is the initial deformation and the orange is after 1 day, and we can see that the nylon deforms quite a lot, so it is not good against the creeping. It will deform under the constant load. On the others, well, it cannot see good on this table, but the best is a polycarbonate. If you watch the difference between these 2 days, we can see this on this graph, and again here we can see that the huge difference is with the nylon, and the best is the polycarbonate, then ABS, ASA filaments and similar. The deformation temperature. So I have here these test objects and a small M10 nut as a load, and I'm measuring the deformation temperature. And here we can see that the nylon is far the best than polycarbonate, and of course the PLA is very weak in this test because it will deform even if you forget them, for example, in a car on hot summer day. Now, even in these PLAs, I excluded the Fileticum PLA filaments. I'm not sure what they're doing with their filaments, but they have PLA materials which resist to temperatures up to 110, even 150. You can check the engineering PLA video about this. And for the end, I don't have the graph or statistics here, but the most wear and scratch resistant filament is hard TPU. I have a separate video about this. And the biggest friction, if you want to, for example, to print some kind of legs for some equipment or something like that, then you should use the soft TPU. Of course, all these statistics is based only on those filaments which I tested, but I believe this number of the testing is quite big enough so we can get some overall pictures about mechanical properties of these filament types. And of course, sometimes we have some bigger standard deviation. For example, there are some ABS materials which are not so impact resistant, or we have some PLA filaments which are tougher compared to some ABS materials. But I cannot include everything in this video. For this, you can check the data separately for each video, or you can become a Patreon supporter. This is my only gift to them, so this is why I cannot include these numbers in this video. And a small reminder, if you like this kind of videos, click the notification bell button too, because in most cases the notification is not sent even to my subscribers. And for the end, small gift for those who are still watching the video. Let's say you have the project which you need a material which resists the best to the bending. Recently I have to print some holder for this dial indicator, and I need it to be stiff as much as possible. PETG was not strong enough in this case, and I checked my summary table for my Patreon supporters, and I just placed an order from the strongest to the weakest for that bending test. And I found out that the strongest material for this is the YX Polyair PCCF, polycarbonate reinforced with carbon fibers. It is very brittle, the filament itself, it will break if you bend it, so it is not really printable on any printer. For example, you can check K1 Max review video. It was not able to print with this filament because it bends too much in the Teflon tube and it breaks. I was able to print it on the X1 Carbon Bamboo printer, but this is extremely strong filament. In that creep test, almost doesn't have any kind of deformation after 5 or 6 days. This would be it from my side. Thank you for watching and happy printing!